And here it is, game three of the championship singles final in the USCA AC Nationals. Loretta Cooper and Tom Cooper are your tournament directors. Johnny Mitchell is the tournament manager at the NCC. Brian Hovis doing the excellent videography. And many thanks again to our sponsors, Chris Barley and Stuart Price. We are, of course, the official YouTube channel of the USCA, which sponsors as well. You can get everything you need to know about croquet from the USCA. Check it out, sign up, and join us on the lawn. Matthew Essick won game one in a fairly straightforward triple peel. Zach Watson came back in a scrapper to even the score. And here we are, one game for all the marbles. Du Bois chatting with Ursula Peck, the heart and soul of the USCA office, with a little help from Johnny and Stephanie. A wide super shot, just like he used in game one. That would ordinarily call for maximum distance on the east boundary by Matthew. But he's going to use an opening that I think Danny Honeycutt has popularized. You can do this either by shooting gently at blue from corner one or doing what Matthew's doing. It may or may not give him a double target from corner one. And Chris Clark actually suggests that a shot about half that length can be confusing even to players like Robert Fletcher. Kind of a deep reverse duffer tice. Zach thought about the corner one response and decided, what the hell, my mojo's working today. Let's go for it. Sometimes the blue is even further west. You can shoot at it and go into corner two. But in this case, if he misses, it's going to give Matthew an easy pickup from the end of B-ball. I don't know whether to call this style aggressive or Monte Carlo, Wiley's four humors. But at the very least, he's in the tug of war with himself. He really wants to get a break going, and that's compromising the leave he ends up with, because he makes it from so far away. I would guess this shot on red to be about 12, 13 yards. Pretty sure that's less than Matthew's critical distance. It might seem a little risky to leave blue and red so close together when you're that far away from the hoop you have to make. But at this level, these guys are good not at just hitting this shot, but at setting it up. The most important shot in AC Croquet, the long rush. I think in game one he made a point of putting partner at hoop six. Here he's obviously not doing that. Whether he's reserving the option of setting up the sextuple or not, I don't know. One of Chris Clark's four criteria for the position of black in this mom standard leave is that black not be easily rushable to hoop one in case the opponent gets in. Matthew obviously disagrees, and he's going to use it in about 10 minutes. Thank you. The usual practice here is the Roquet blue, put it on the wire, and then take red to the east boundary. Matthew did it this way in game one, and he's doing it so that he gets a nice little rush on blue, so that he's guaranteed to get the right placement of blue on hoop four. But it's a little trickier to get the wiring when you have to place red first. Not to mention dangerous. Had red gone out, Zach's got a four ball break. So Matthew's the first to make nine. As we said before, picking up blue makes Matthew's triple a little harder, maybe. Let's see what Zach likes here. So theoretically, the only question here is, when does he go after blue? A Hogan roll after one or two? Or do it delayed at before or after hoop four? Oh yeah, and is he going to rush yellow to one or two? Because he remembers that he intentionally left black rushable to hoop one, he has the choice. When I first met Matthew, he was 14 or 15, and he basically never missed anything, and that was the key to his success. As he gets older, though, and as I find out from asking him questions about why he does what he does on these videos, the explanations are frequently professorial in content and length. He's becoming a master tactician. And even when he was 14, Danny Honeycutt said he never had to explain anything to him twice. He's not taking the P lead to four back because he doesn't have a hoop four pioneer. And he's got to pick a blue out of the corner. So setting up the delayed triple peel. These guys are luckier than the rest of us for a reason. Ooh, maybe he can get it back on time. Make the penult peel before one bag. Thank you. jawsing that penalty attempt is just fine because it gives him a rush peel toward Rover after one back, which is certainly better than having yellow go through penult by an inch. And we interrupt this broadcast for a quick look at court 7, where Linda Sutterberg from corner 3 is pegging out to win the first flight championship of the 2023 AC Nationals. As we've said before, she and Arlene Parker are the first two women to compete in this final. Linda won it 26-6. Ending a fabulous run for Arlene Parker and putting the frosting on the cake of her own. I met Linda in Columbus in 2012. I think she was a 9 handicap. Her husband, Steve Grassball, and I have been chasing her ever since. Her lead only gets bigger. A wonderful milestone. In In the meantime, Matthew Croquet black to four back, Russ yellow to the south boundary, and is approaching three back with the rover peel yet to be done. Zach's probably thinking about what he wants to have for lunch about now. I don't think this shot is close to either limit, but it is fun to ask yourself how far away and at what angle does this shot have to be before you would bail out to a stop shot peel as opposed to an Irish peel. You'll get a lot of different answers about that one. He can't believe it. I think he's pretty upset because it's not that he's ahead 23-0. It's that he's only ahead by 2 breaks. And against Zach and certainly against Patty Chapman or Reg or Robert Fletcher, his chance of losing is now very real. And you don't get to be world champion without setting the bar pretty high for yourself. Does he pick up blue or black? Because he gets a lift, obviously. Picks up black, he's got to do a pretty funky stop shot to get yellow to 2 and still have a chance of rushing blue to hoop 1. Picks up blue, then it's the standard drive shot that sends yellow to 2 and gets blue behind black with a rush to 1. So yellow's for the peg, red is for Rover. He's going to shoot red every time unless yellow has a really short shot. You think it's over, don't you? Trust me, this would be a bad time to change channels. Well, that's atypical. His grandmother's getting worried for him by now. And if Red hadn't rolled into the peg, he probably would have pegged it out anyway, because yellow is for the peg. Otherwise, pegging out partner is seldom a good idea. Pete Trimmer covers the two-on-one game exhaustively in Beyond Expert Croquet. It is not an easy read. Zach's basic job is to wire yellow from the peg and then set a trap in the corner such that if yellow shoots and misses, he gets a three-ball break. And of course, he'll be responsible for yellow's position most of the time, so he has to give yellow a ball to shoot at. And because red pegged out, yellow does not get any hoop lifts. These games can take a while because he'll do this every time.
You gotta be
This looks more like a hook into the 1-3 pin pocket by a right-handed bowler than a croquet shot. He actually apologized to Zach for that shot afterward. Like I said, the great ones are luckier than the rest of us because they're better than the rest of us. If he doesn't finish now, he's going to need some therapy. Maybe the least satisfying peg out of his career. But it makes him the 2023 USCA AC National Champion in a repeat performance. And now some awards. Second place, first flight double. Steve Mendick and Loretta Cooper lost to Linda Sutterberg and Sandy Knuth, who couldn't be here.
Championship doubles. Matthew Essick, Kyle Malou.
Stuart Lawrence won the championship flight plate.
100% three wins and no losses.
Sharif Abdulwahab got second place in the plate.
Okay, amateur singles.
Amateur, I love that. He means first flight, of course.
Arlene Parker, you played exceptionally well. And the winner, amateur singles, Linda Sutterberg. The hometown favorite.
Not to mention our all-girl final.
Yeah, all-girl finals.
Historic.
Watch out, Matthew, here we come.
On the outside are Tom and Loretta Cooper, your tournament directors, and flanking the players are Carla Rook and Preston Stewart, representing the USCA.
The runner-up, Zach Watson.
And the winner.
A repeat performance. The reigning champion, Matthew Essick.
So give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. We have the Southeast Regional American Rules Tournament coming up. Thanks again to our sponsors at the USCA, Chris Barley and Stuart Price. There they are, 1-2 in the U.S. I think Matthews has at least 9 and maybe 10 or 11 national championships to go with his second place in the AC Worlds, and he is the reigning World Golf Croquet Champion. They're on their way to Hurlingham in England for the AC Worlds, and we wish them the best of luck.